Hi, I'm Sander Houdek. I'm a physical therapist in Sophia Rehabilitation Center here in The Hague. And next to my assignment as a physical therapist, I also have a function in innovating our healthcare here. Sophia Rehabilitation Center is a medical specialistic rehabilitation, which means that we are always working with several healthcare people, for example, physical therapists, psychologists, doctors, ergotherapists, together to help patients who, for example, suffered a stroke, regain function and participate in life. The most important thing we do here is getting people after they suffered a stroke to participate in life. So all the things we do has the goal to make life easier for the patients. So most of the time there are daily activities like cooking, walking, going to the supermarket, keep your house clean, planning your daily activities, all that kind of things. After stroke, many things can happen to you. Stroke can you can have difficulties in walking, using your upper limb, but also problems in speech, understanding, memory. All those kind of things you do with your brain, and if there's damage on some part of your brain, it can cause problems. So the most obvious one is if you can't move your leg, you can't walk anymore. And we have to help people regain walking ability. But also when there are memory problems, we can learn people how to cope with memory problems by using an agenda, for example, and making their life structured. Mm-hmm. So it's easier for them to participate again. What happened to patients who suffer stroke is that in the brain, the vessels provide the brain from oxygen. And when you have a stroke, there can two things can happen. For the most of the time, there is something blocking the bloodstream in the vein, and the area behind the blocked vein suffers oxygen, a lack of oxygen, and cells are dying in the brain. And those cells provide the function you do in daily life. So most of the time it happens very fast. You sit on your chair and suddenly your mouth is falling away. You can't speak anymore and your limb on one side of your body is not moving anymore. Well, then it's very important to go to the hospital, to be in the hospital as soon as possible. And in the hospital, they're trying to keep you alive. After that, if you're stable, then it depends on how severe the problems you have are. And they choose to go to bring you to back to home, sometimes with a physical therapist at home. But when it's more severe, there are also choices for a rehabilitation center. So you can live here, actually. You can have a room and an whole team who is helping you in a safe environment. And you can also, here in the rehabilitation center, get rehabilitation from home. So you come from home to us, and there we help you. Again, with several paramedics and medics to obtain your your life again, to get your life back again. As a physical therapist, we call ourselves the experts in movement. So most of the things we do is getting people to walk again, or support walking with, for example, walking aids, sticks, but also ankle foot orthoses. And we try to learn people strategies, how to cope with less function in the leg or arm. So that's the main thing we do as a physical therapist. Well, when a patient is here, for example, he's here clinical, so he's living here. When the patients are coming here, then we meet them and we'll check what can you do on your own and where do you need help for your safety. So that's the first contact I have with patients. And the next day I will have an intake with the patients and see, okay, what kind of disabilities do you experience in moving your body, and what's important for you to train. And from there on, we make a plan to rehabilitate patients. When a patient is going home, there has to be the general practitioner is the one who is getting the lead of the healthcare for that patient again. We give advice what kind of healthcare is still needed for the patient when he's going home. And most of the time, that's the nurse care at home. They provide you the right medicine in the morning, can help you shower, put on your clothes, for example. And sometimes there are a physical therapist at home or an ergotherapist at home still needed. The difference with us is that they don't have communication like we do in one company. So the general practitioner has to coordinate more what kind of help is given to the patient. And when the patient is going home, sometimes there are adjustments at home needed, and the city is providing the financial support to adjust their home. So for example, the shower has to be a walk-in shower instead of a shower where you have to get in or out of the tub. A walk-in closet is, for example, much more safer for patients who have difficulties with walking. The caregivers, of course, the wife or the husband of the patient has a very important role. Both lives are really changing, and the caregiver sometimes has to help patients in daily activities instead of just being his husband or wife. That's also a very important person for the patient, husband, wife, but also neighbor, cousin, friend. Yeah. If we take the daily activity cooking, and the patient is still clinical here in Sophia Rehabilitation. What we'll do is the patient wants to be able to cook again. Most of the time, our ergotherapist is going to perform the task with the patient. First, he's doing all kind of tests to see what could probably go wrong and what could probably go still the way it should be. And then going to perform the task and see how the patient is performing a task. So the ergotherapist is the main practitioner who's practicing. and see and checking what is going good or right. A physical therapist can help, for example, if there are movement problems, lifting up a pen. So we're going to practice that in our time with the patient. And a physical therapist is, for example, helping when there's severe angst,
anxiety,
for example, for cooking. If it's go wrong, what is happening? But also coping. Is there really problems with coping with what happened with the patients? Depressions, those kind of things. Also, that involves how you perform the task, cooking. So everybody is again involved. If the patient is going to cook with the ergotherapist, the ergotherapist is going to look at the task and several domains. So how is the patient perceiving his environment? Does he recognize a pen, a broccoli? Does he recognize that he is in the kitchen, for example? All those things is needed to perform a task in a normal way. So that's the first thing he's looking at. Is he perceiving his environment and his obstacles he sees in the way it should be? And if that is going right, what is he going to recall of those objects and environment? Does he still know that in a kitchen there should be a cooking task? Or does he still know that a broccoli is a vegetable that you can eat, for example? And if you can eat it, that you probably put it in a pan and cook it. And all those kind of things are memories, and you know how to perform it. It could be difficult after a stroke. So that's the second step. He is checking how a patient is performing a task. So you have perceiving, knowing what everything is. Recalling is knowing what it means, all those objects, and what you can do with it. And after that, he's checking how is the patient planning his activity. Does he still know which step after each other has to be taken to obtain the goal of making a good, nice meal? So for example, does he know if you're going to cook the broccoli, that he has to first cut the broccoli, then put it in a pan, water in it, on the stove. How long does it has to be on the stove? That's planning your activity. And in that planning, you make, before you do it, a plan how you're going to do it. Perform domain is, are you able to evaluate your plan during execution? So for example, you made the plan to cut the broccoli, but the knife you had in mind isn't available. What are you going to do? Which knife you're choosing then, for example. But also what is going on with people with stroke is, normally I lift up the pan with two hands when it's filled with cooked water. How am I going to obtain the task with one hand? So you have to be able to evaluate, identify barriers, and also come up with solution during cooking to perform the task well. Well, there's a whole lot of analyzing to do for an ergotherapist, and after that he can give strategies to patients to perform the task in a way that is executed in a manner that he has a nice meal at the end of the task. If the patient is at home, probably the caregiver is looking at the shoulder of the patient, how he's performing the task, without any expert knowledge. But a caregiver knows how somebody performed before and can see very well what is different. And because a healthy person is able to identify barriers and come up with solutions, probably the caregiver will give some help and some extra tips. Maybe you should do this, maybe you should do that. The most difficult part, if things are really going wrong, the caregiver always has to be there. And that's a lot of work if you have to be there at cooking, but also all the other different daily activities.